So now the real dodginess begins. This is the second part of my video about this electric heated shower head, known as a suicide shower. In the first part I was taking a look inside, explaining how does it work and doing some calculations. And there is a link to it in the description. And now I'm going to actually test it and do some measurements. So I've connected a cable to it with a normal European plug, and first I'm going to test it using a normal socket. I will set it to a low power setting, which according to my calculations should draw about 16 or 17 amps. And if I'm lucky, my circuit breaker may not trip. My wall sockets have a 16 amp breaker. So what's your opinion on this? Now it's not yet in power, so let's just try the water. And the water goes from it, and it also leaks here, and that's nice. And now let's test it with power. Set it to low, stick it in power, turn it on, and what's going to happen? Is it hot? It seems like my breaker tripped. And it's actually not the breaker, it's my RCD or GFI, which trips at 30 milliamps. So let's plug it in a different room, with no RCD. And now a second try, turn it on, turn water on. Water is coming from it, it's nicely warm and the current is 16.4 amps. So my calculation was quite close. Now the question is, what happens if I set it to high power? Let's try it. About 23 amps. That's quite a current. And the water is nicely warm. Let's reduce the flow a little bit. And now it's quite hot. It seems to work. Now let's measure the ground current here. And it's going to be bloody hell, 190 milliamps. That's crazy. This is definitely more than I expected, and it's no wonder that the RCD is tripping. Now let's try low power setting. About 130 milliamps. Now is it backfeeding any voltage into the water pipes? Let's measure it. One terminal goes to the ground pin and the other one goes to the water pipe. Let's turn it on. And that's about 10 volts. 10 volts in the water pipe. And what about here? 7 volts. Now, what's the voltage in the water coming from it? Not so bad. About 6 or 7 volts when it's right under it, which is not so bad. Now the current. Now, how much does the mains voltage actually drop under the load? High power. And low power. And those pipes are plastic, of course. Now, can I measure the current in this hose like this? It's less than 1 milliamp. Because of the resistance of water, the backfeeding current is very low. And also the current going into you is low because of the resistance of water and the resistance of your body. What if I put my hand under it? It's nicely warm and nothing happens because I'm not grounded. So now let's actually ground myself and measure the current. Still no shock. Still nothing. There is some leakage, but I can't feel anything. The water is warm. And there is some current, but not noticeable. What if I ground myself using this metal plate? Now it's getting very dodgy. Of course. No current. No shock. Still no current, no shock. There is some current now, but not noticeable. I still can't feel anything. And it's with a wet hand now. Because in some countries there is no ground, and because it trips the RCD, a lot of people install it not grounded. I have seen a lot of pictures and videos of this one installed with the ground disconnected. So let's try to see what happens if it's not connected. So let's measure the voltage in the water. It's about half of the mains voltage. Now the current. It's very low until you go directly under it. Now it's a lot, but here it's already very low. So is it finally going to give me a shock? Let's ground myself, measure the current and touch it. So let's test it. No current, no shock. Let's get closer and now I feel some current. There is definitely some current. Now it's very unpleasant. Now it's very unpleasant. About 2 milliamps. But when I put my hand here, it's okay. So to get a shock, I have to actually get very close to it, about here. Now it's giving me a shock. That's very unpleasant. Now there is about 60 volts in the pipes. That's nice. And about 45 volts in this one. So it's backfeeding some voltage into the pipes, but because of the resistance of the water, the current is very low. Less than 1 milliamp. When it's not grounded, it doesn't trip the RCD. Can I trip my RCD by putting something grounded under it? Now it trips again. So it's definitely an interesting device. I tried to install it the traditional Latin America style and I survived it. And as you can see, safety is quite relative. What's absolutely unacceptable in one country can be completely normal in another country. Countries in South America or Central America usually don't have a heater for the entire house. Those countries are probably too hot to have a heating system for the entire building. So they use those. And those showers are supposed to be grounded, but in some of those countries there is no ground available. Especially older buildings in those countries probably have no ground wires. So those showers are very often installed with the ground wire not connected. And if the building has ground, but it also has an RCD, it keeps tripping because the ground leakage current of those showers is very high. So people often bypass the RCD or disconnect the ground wire of this shower. Sometimes the ground connection of the shower is probably connected with neutral, because there is no ground or because the RCD keeps tripping. If the neutral has no potential in it, it's probably better than leaving this one in the air. But if the neutral breaks, or if the life and the neutral are inverted, it makes it even worse. And it's very often installed with the wires just twisted, which is not a good idea because the current is very high, about 25 amps. And there is also a 110 volt version of it for 110 volt countries, where the current probably is about 50 amps. And the wires are often too thin, so it may catch a fire. The switch, of course, shouldn't be moved when it's on, and you also shouldn't touch it with wet hands. So I tested it in both situations, grounded and not grounded. And it turns out that if it's grounded properly, it's almost impossible to get a shock from it. Even if your body is grounded and you touch the nozzles directly, you probably don't get a shock, because the voltage in the water at the nozzles is very low, thanks to this grounding electrode at the outlet. But if it's not grounded, it's a bit worse, because the voltage at the nozzles is much higher, it's about half of the mains voltage. In this condition you can get a shock, especially if your body is well grounded. The worst case is if you are touching something grounded, for example standing in a grounded metal bathtub or touching a grounded metal pipe. In such condition you get close to the shower and get a shock, because the circuit is completed. But if you are not touching anything grounded, it's much less likely to get a shock because you are grounded by just the water you are standing in, and this water goes down the drain. It goes a long path, so it's a higher resistance. So it seems that to get a shock, three circumstances are necessary. The shower head is not grounded, and your body is grounded by, for example, standing on something grounded or touching a grounded metal pipe. And also to get very close to the shower head. If the shower head is not grounded, there is a high voltage at the nozzles, and the circuit is completed from the shower head to the ground. And it seems like that to get a shock you have to get very close to it, because the water comes out from it as a laminar flow, but it goes on for just a few centimeters and then the water breaks into individual droplets. And of course, like this, it can't conduct any current. So I took a picture of it with a flash, and because a camera flash is very short, you can basically see it frozen in time. When tourists see those, they are quite scared of it, because they see those live wires sticking out of it, and what if the water accidentally splashes on it? But this is actually the least concern, because the water is actually coming through this heater, which is live at mains voltage. And as you can see, the grounding wire is getting slightly darkened, slightly oxidized or corroded, but if it's not grounded, this is not a concern, of course. And it's AC current, so most of the electrolysis should cancel out. And there are probably some better versions of this one with the wires plated or from some better material to prevent corrosion. And this heater is also slightly corroded at the ends of it. And as you can see, it's probably replaceable, isn't it? There are connectors, like fastons, This heater element is actually being sold separately as a spare part. And of course, if the heater accidentally runs with no water flow, the entire head will melt. This can happen, for example, if the contacts in it get stuck or welded. So it's an amazing device, it works, but in some circumstances it may give you a shock. And it's definitely not up to a safety standard of rich countries like Europe, UK, US, Canada or Australia. It comes from eBay for about $19 including shipping. Here you can see some keywords and, of course, I don't recommend you to buy it. And it arrived in quite a nice box. But surprisingly, it's not damaged. So this is Diagon Wild and see you in my next videos. And thanks to all of my patrons on Patreon. I really appreciate your support. And the last question is, should I actually get under the shower? And even if I'm standing in the water, I don't get a shock because the water has a high resistance. Now it's running at low power, not grounded of course, as they do it in Latin America, and should I touch it? Actually, I don't get any shock. Even if I put my hand right under it, like this, no shock. And it's nicely warm. And this was done with RCD, which didn't trip.